But check this out, inside Pine Emulator, we are almost getting 80 to 90 FPS while emulating Pokemon Sword on a MediaTek processor Android device with 6GB of RAM. Yo, what's up guys, it's Aptrix here. Once again, we are back with our low-end Android devices, and in today's video, we'll be testing out Pine Emulator on them. Now, if you are new to my channel, then let me tell you guys, this device has Snapdragon 4 Gen 1 processor, whereas this is an MediaTek processor with a Mali GPU. In today's video, we'll be testing out this brand new Nintendo Switch emulator to see how well does it perform on low-end Android devices. And if you guys are new here, I upload similar tests on my channel, so be sure to hit that like button, subscribe, turn on all notification. Let's get started. So to start off, we'll be testing out our Nintendo Switch game on my Snapdragon 4 Gen 1 Android device. Let me show you guys the RAM that is available on this device. You'll be able to see it has the Adreno 619 GPU and it has only 5.4 GB of RAM. Though if you guys have been watching my videos for a long time, then you guys already know I always tell you guys that Pine emulator, which is based on Skyline emulator, it is supposed to be the best Nintendo Switch emulator for low-end Android devices, especially if you have a Snapdragon processor. And in today's video, I'll show you the proof. I'll also talk about the comparison of this FPS compared to other Nintendo Switch emulators like Nushu, which are based on Yuzu emulator. You'll be able to see CPU backend is set to native core execution, audio output engine is auto, enable sustained performance has been disabled, dock mode will also be disabled. And in terms of drivers, this is a pros of Snapdragon processor Android devices. If you use system driver, you will get low FPS. So I recommend you guys to use the Mesa Turnip Adreno drivers. This is the current revision 22 latest update of graphics driver. Make sure to use it. Executor flush threshold will set it to 471. Slot count scale will be set to 6. Let's enable force maximum GPU clocks, free cache texture memory. Afterwards, dynamic resolution will be disabled. We'll also enable fast GPU readback and writes. Once that has been done, let's start testing out our games. The first game which I'll test out is going to be One Piece Unlimited World Red. Let's find out if this game actually works or not. And I have also loaded up similar games on my MediaTek processor Android device. And immediately you'll be able to see that this game is booting, even though my device has very less RAM, like 5.4 GB. But still, the game booted successfully and we are getting pretty amazing FPS at the top left corner. And there we go guys, this is the first cutscene, 60 FPS, no issues whatsoever, has surprisingly started. And you'll be able to still see we are getting around 42 FPS, which is really amazing gameplay experience, no issues whatsoever. On a Snapdragon 4 Gen 1 Android device, this is very impressive because it literally means that even if you have a low-end Android device, you should be able to emulate Nintendo Switch games at 1x graphics resolution, which is pretty amazing to be honest. We are literally emulating a 3D open world Nintendo Switch title on our Android devices inside the Pine emulator. So let's move on towards our next game, which is going to be Pokemon Legends Arceus. And let's see if this actually works or not. Pokemon Legends Arceus is very high-end title. As you know, one of the first open world Pokemon games. And this time you guys will be able to notice that we are getting around 16 to 17 FPS during the cutscene. So you already saw, we were emulating an open world high graphic game before. And still, if you try playing Pokemon Legends Arceus on a low-end Android device, the FPS immediately dropped down to 16. Let me skip this cutscene. And here we go guys, our game is about to start and the FPS has increased by a little bit, but that doesn't mean anything. Let's wait until we see the first cutscene and open world areas. Pokemon Legends Arceus, pretty amazing, even on a low-end Android device it managed to boot. Now let's see if there are any crashing issues or not. It is stuck at 12 FPS. Alright guys, the game was indeed frozen, so I just restarted it and have added a save file, so this time there shouldn't be any sort of cutscene. And if the game manages to boot, then we will be able to play it right away. Alright, there we go guys, Pokemon Legends Arceus has successfully started on this low-end Android device, though it's not at all playable. Just take a look at the FPS at the top left corner, we are getting around 8 to 9 FPS. But hear me out, if you want to play Pokemon game on your low-end Android device, you can only play Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu or Pokemon Sword. Pokemon Legends Arceus Scarlet, you can't really play them. But hey, at least it is working, that's what makes it pretty amazing. Let's just go ahead and close game and try out our last game, which is going to be Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu. And this time we'll just go ahead and open settings and here make sure that the dock mode is disabled. And I forgot to enable one option, which was disable frame throttling. With this enabled, now we should be getting more than 30 FPS at least during the cutscenes etc. So it makes loading screens lot faster. You will be able to see we are getting around 100 FPS during the loading screen of Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu. But what matters is how will the game perform once it actually starts. Let's tap on the A button to start our game. And here we go guys, the game has successfully started. We are getting around 17 to 18 FPS, which is 100% playable experience, but there will be some stuttering issues. Make sure to keep that in mind. Once the shaders are compiled, you won't face any stuttering issues. But in my opinion, this is a very playable gameplay experience, and if you have a low-end Snapdragon processor Android device, then you can definitely give this game a try. With that being said, that was Pine Emulator on a low-end Snapdragon processor Android device. Now let's try it out on a MediaTek processor Android device. The settings which I'll apply will be similar, so dock mode disable, show performance statistics, aspect ratio will be device aspect ratio. Afterwards, disable frame throttling, native code execution set as CPU backend. Force maximum GPU clocks cannot be enabled as it says your device does not support forcing maximum GPU clocks. Let's enable fast readback and writes. And one thing which is different is you can't really use custom graphics driver as MediaTek processor don't really have any kind of custom graphics driver. Let's try out our first game, which is going to be One Piece Unlimited World Raid. This device also has same 6GB RAM. And there we go, the game has successfully started, but we are getting 200 FPS. Just comparatively, like this has MediaTek Dimensity 8100 processor, whereas this had Snapdragon 4 Gen 1 processor. So you can compare the performance for yourself. Even on low-end devices, you will be able to see we are at least able to boot up some Nintendo Switch games. And there we go, the game has successfully started. Let me skip all the cutscenes. And you will be able to see that we are getting 100 FPS while emulating a Nintendo Switch game on a MediaTek processor Android device. Anyways, this FPS is pretty amazing and pretty stable, so Dimensity 8100. If you want your MediaTek processor Android device's full potential in terms of Nintendo Switch emulation, obviously you gotta go for this emulator. Let's close the game and let's try out different titles, for example Legends Arceus, Pokemon Sword and Let's Go Pikachu. Let's start with Legends Arceus and see if it actually works or not. And in my opinion, I don't think it will work, but there we go, the game has actually booted. This is very unexpected. And I think this is because of the Strato emulator parts which Pine Emulator has included. I can't believe it, guys. Pokemon Legends Arceus is actually starting. I didn't think this would happen because inside Skyline Emulator, as far as I remember, MediaTek processor wasn't able to play any games. Okay, the game has crashed, so let me add a save file and I'll be back. Alright guys, I have imported the save file as you will be able to see. Let's find out if this time the game manages to run or not. Presented by Game Freak, Pokemon Legends Arceus, press A to start. I think it will crash after the loading screen, but if it actually goes in game, then I believe it might be because of the Strato emulator code that has been used inside of the Pine emulator. Okay, the game has crashed. So as I expected, it shouldn't really be playable. Let's move to our next game, which will be Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu. And we'll be trying out Pokemon Sword for the last. And I have also imported Let's Go Pikachu save file, so it should be able to boot pretty soon. And as far as my predictions go, this game should successfully work on my MediaTek processor Android device. As it is an old game, as you guys can see, we are getting 90 FPS while emulating Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu on a MediaTek processor Android device. This literally beats all the emulators like New Shoe Xiang's, because Skyline emulator is peak, bro. I am literally getting almost the same amount of FPS which I get on my Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 Android device. So it is using the full potential of MediaTek Dimensity processors, and this is why I think Pine Emulator is pretty good, and I by mistakenly threw Master Ball for a PG. Anyway, this brings us to the main point of our today's video. If you have low-end Android devices, go with Pine Emulator. Anyways, our final game will be Pokemon Sword, the big boy. I'm not really sure if this will work or not, because I knew about Legends Arceus and I also knew about Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu that it would work, but I'm completely unsure about Pokemon Sword. So let's find out if it works or not. The cutscene has started properly, so I think it should work. And one important fact which I forgot to talk about, Pokemon Sword doesn't even boot on the newest versions of New Shoe Emulator or Zinx Emulator, whereas in Pine Emulator, this game managed to boot, which is so impressive to be honest, guys. Inside any other Nintendo Switch emulator for Android, you can't play Pokemon Sword on a Mali GPU Android device. But check this out, inside Pine Emulator, we are almost getting 80 to 90 FPS while emulating Pokemon Sword on a MediaTek processor Android device with 6GB of RAM. Oh my god, what's going on, bro? I am getting 90 FPS. This is super crazy, guys. I didn't expect this at all. And there we go, the game didn't crash after I exited the house, but oops, I think I spoke too soon or it's just compiling shaders. Who knows, but the FPS has dropped down to 19 to 20, which is completely acceptable, and once all the shaders are compiled, I'm pretty sure the FPS will go up. You'll be able to see at the top left corner, and you'll be able to see once the open world scenarios actually start, we are getting almost 30 FPS. So yeah guys, that was the conclusion of our today's video. Be sure to hit that like button, subscribe, turn on all notifications, and let me know what you guys think about the performance of Pine Emulator, which is a fork version of Skyline Emulator on low-end Android devices. I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.